Good morning children, welcome to class 5 social studies. So today we are going to start with a new lesson, movements of the earth. Movements means how the earth moves. Okay, that one, what are the different types of movements, that one we are going to see. So first children, the people were thinking in ancient days, they believed that the earth was at the center of the universe. Okay, so imagine this to be a universe. They thought this earth was at the center and the sun was revolving around it. Okay, the sun was revolving around the earth, like that they were thinking. But a scientist named Nicholas Copernicus, a Polish astronomer, he is from Poland, so he is called as Polish. Okay, so a Polish astronomer, Nicholas Copernicus, proved that the earth is rotating around the sun. Okay, the earth spins on its axis. So this one also I have shown you children, this one axis. Okay, the center point from north pole to south pole is called as your axis. So the earth rotates on its axis and this earth revolves around the sun, like that they have proved that. So this was again proved by one more scientist. His name is Galileo Galilei. His name is Galileo Galilei. He also told that sun is at the center and the all other planets move around the sun. So, okay, once again I repeat. Nicholas Copernicus told that the earth revolves around the sun, and it is added to him belief. One more this one, Galileo Galilei, he told sun is at the center and all the planets revolve around the sun. Now coming over here, there are two movements you can observe with the earth children. Okay, with related to itself, the earth itself, and the another one is as it moves around the sun. So the two types of movements are, one is rotation and another one is revolution. Okay, one is rotation and another one is revolution. So we will study in detail what is rotation, what is revolution. Okay, so this one with the globe I will show you. So children, see, you know in the previous class and all you have learned what is axis. So this is your axis from north pole to south pole. One imaginary line is over here, okay, that one gives you the axis. So the rotation means the earth rotates on its own axis. Okay, from here to here the earth rotates on its own axis, and it rotates from west, this side is west, west to east. Okay, like this it rotates west to east. Then it, to rotate itself, it takes 24 hours for one rotation. That's why we tell we have 24 hours in a day. It includes both day and night. So it takes 24 hours to make one rotation like this. Okay, then as this rotation is there, it causes day and night. So okay children, imagine here the globe is here, the sunlight is falling over this place. Okay, the earth is rotating. So what happens, wherever the part of earth which receives sunlight will be day. So what happens to the back side? It will not get the sunlight now here, this side. So it will be night. So as the earth starts rotating, we will have this side wherever it gets sunlight, it is day, and the other side of the part of earth will be night. So this rotation only causes your day and night. Are you getting children? Okay, once again I repeat, the rotation of the earth and the direction from the sunlight gives you the day and night. Next one, we have discussed these northern, this part is your polar regions. Okay, this side is Arctic and this side is Antarctica, polar regions. So the polar regions, what happens, you will have, when the earth is rotating, this is your northern hemisphere and this is your southern hemisphere. So what happens when the sunlight falls over here and it starts rotating, this polar regions will not get the sunlight much, okay, both north pole and south pole. So what happens, for 6 months you will have summer over here in the side, that is above horizon, the sun is above horizon. See, the sun rays are falling on the earth like this. So we have discussed what is horizon, the way, the place or the thing where the sky and your land meet like that. So when you stand in an open land and see, sometimes you feel like the sky and the land meet. So that is called horizon. So okay, when the sun is above the horizon, see, imagine like this. So the sun's rays is above like this, means this part you will have summer, whereas this part will receive less sunlight, so it will be winter over here. Okay, that is only written here, polar regions, 6 months summer in which the sun is above horizon, whereas 6 months winter when the sun is below horizon. So you have different times, you have day and night. So you could have observed in India, if it is now morning 10:30, means in America it will be night 10:30. Almost a 12-hour difference is there for with us. Okay, anything, if you move from India, you have Singapore, or if you go back go to Japan, or this side if you come Western Asian countries, you will have a time difference of 4 hours, 5 hours, like that. They will be saying it is night for us, now only it is afternoon for us. Because why? Because wherever the sunlight you get, that part will be the day. Okay, as it starts rotating, you will have the changing of times, like a day and night you will get. Okay children, now coming to your next one, revolution. So these things are the points in the rotation, and the next one we are going to see is the revolution. Okay, revolution means, see, imagine the earth has its own axis and it rotates, then we call it as rotation. Whereas in the revolution, the sun is at the center and the earth around the sun. Okay, so sun is over here means, okay, so what happens, the earth will move in an oval shape. Okay, like this only your all remaining 8 planets move around the sun, children. Okay, so some, imagine earth is over here, so the earth moves around the sun in an oval path. This oval path is called your orbit. Okay, this oval path is called your orbit, and the earth moves around the sun. Okay, that moves around the sun in an oval shaped path called orbit. The sun in a fixed path is known as revolution. Okay, are you getting this one? As the earth rotates around the sun, this is called revolution. So children, the earth rotates itself and it moves around the sun also. Okay, once again I repeat, see what the earth does. The earth rotates itself and it moves around the sun like this. Are you getting? Okay, once again I repeat, the earth rotates itself and moves around the sun like this and comes up. So okay, so it takes nearly 365 1/4 days to complete one revolution. So it takes 365 1/4 days to complete one revolution. And you can tell in time means 365 days and 6 hours. 365 days and 6 hours it takes to complete one revolution. Okay, then next one, so the next one you have have the, as the earth completes one revolution, its tilted axis is towards, okay children, as the earth is like this, it is tilted towards the sun. So imagine the sun's rays coming and falling over the globe, okay. Then you have the northern hemisphere here and the southern hemisphere. So the sun's rays falls on this, which is closer to the sun's rays will get more sunlight, which is far away from the sunlight will get less sunlight. Okay, so these are the points. Then you have, it develops, it gives you as this sun, depending on the sun's rays falling on the earth, we have the four different seasons. That is your four seasons: summer, winter, so first one summer, winter, autumn, and one more is spring season. Okay, depending on the seasons only we celebrate our festivals. Okay, summer means it will be very hot, and winter you feel the cold. In autumn means, have you observed children, the leaves will be falling, so that season is your autumn season. And the spring season means the new leaves will start coming from the tree, so that time you can tell that is spring season. Okay, so we have four seasons: summer, winter, autumn, and spring. Okay, then the same point once again. As this northern hemisphere is tilted more towards the sun, you will get more sunlight, and you will get summer over here. And this southern hemisphere is far away from the light, so you will get the winter season over here in the southern hemisphere, children. So we will continue with the next class. Thank you, children.